If there's any place in the world that you would hope and expect to feel safe, it would be at your house. But sometimes that's just not the case. Welcome to The Supreme. I'm your host, Matty Willz, and today we'll be looking at some of the scariest cases of people finding the most unwanted things in and around their homes with today's title, 5 Terrifying Things People Found in Their Backyards. Want to become part of the Supreme Team? Make sure to subscribe down below with notifications on so you don't miss anything we post each day. Let's get rolling. Old bones. So let's say that you recently purchased your first home and you can't wait to get into it and make all of the appropriate changes that you and your family were desperate to make. If the house you're purchasing isn't brand new and it's been around for a while, then there's a pretty good chance that you're going to run into a couple of things that may surprise you. We've shown you stories of people finding unwanted and sometimes even illegal things in their basements and attics, and this time we'll show you something that completely shook up the new home purchaser that was actually found right outside in their yard. A guy named Don Shelby was working with a company who was attempting to work on some plumbing for a home that was recently bought. Don worked for Dependable Plumbing and was in the process of upgrading the family's water main. It's believed that the original one that was installed back in the 1920s was made out of lead, and the new homeowners wanted that to be switched out, and understandably so. Anyway, once the crew got about 5 feet underground, their machines bumped into something that definitely wasn't loose soil. As it turned out, it was a human skull. At first, Don thought it was just a rock or something of that sort, so he continued to dig until the skull could be seen in full, at which point the crew stopped all of their work and contacted the local authorities. Once the police arrived and continued to dig into the ground, an entire skeletal system was uncovered. And one of the strange things about the find was that this fully grown system was buried in the fetal position, with no other articles of anything found close by. As it turns out, these bones were about 1,000 years old. It was ultimately determined that this system was part of the Fremont Indian tribe, which was also one of 7 complete skeletal systems of the same tribe that had been found over the span of about 10 or 15 years in the same neighborhood. Pretty creepy, huh? I mean, how many times have you been doing some work on your home underground and uncovered someone's old bones? Well, hopefully not very often. So before we're able to move on, I've got to show you this image that was recently sent in to the Supreme family. Check this thing out. What in the world is that? Some strange and highly unusual creature, one that none of us here on the Supreme family has ever seen before, can be seen right here. But what the heck is it? And where the heck did it come from? You can tell that the ruler placed in front of it shows that the animal had a wingspan that's at least 1 foot long, but unfortunately that doesn't tell us a whole heck of a lot about what it is or where it comes from. Burning meteorite. We'll move on. Now, this next video comes with some question marks, at least for people who have viewed it online. A man in Georgia back in the summer of 2017 claimed that he discovered a burning meteorite that fell right into his yard. Check it out. You can even see the fallen space rock is still on fire as it rests in front of the camera. But do you believe the story? The man named Jay Sullivan says that he was just hanging out in his home when he heard a very loud crash that sounded like it came from right in front of his house. He stated that he originally thought it was a car crash because of how loud it was. In the video, you can see the man run out to the area in his yard where he claims the meteorite landed. The circumference of the crash site was about 15 inches across, and you can even see the little rock was still on fire once the camera arrived. So, what do you think? Real or fake? Well, according to the American Meteor Society, this event was undoubtedly, drumroll please, fake. As a matter of fact, they said that this event was super fake. According to the experts, meteorites aren't even hot when they hit the ground, as those guys and gals state that Hollywood has wrongly convinced all of us that they are. They also said that a meteorite that size is not even large enough to leave an impact crater. So, whoever did all of this did it for the theatrics and not for the science. But I gotta say, they went through a lot to convince us that this event actually occurred, so I'll go ahead and give them just a little bit of credit for that. Practice bomb. From old bones to scary meteors. Oops, I mean not so scary meteors. Up next, we've certainly got something that would cause us all to proceed very carefully. According to the Miami Herald, back in early June of 2019, a very scary bomb was found by some kids. And the bomb actually dated all the way back to World War II. I know, pretty insane, right? In Boca Raton, according to the report, a few children were out in the yard digging holes, looking for rocks and worms. What they ended up discovering was much more dangerous than either of those things. After its discovery, the mother contacted the local authorities and the police and bomb squad arrived. This specific device was an MK-43, otherwise known as a practice bomb, and most certainly was a danger to the community. The mother posted the bomb to her social media, where dozens of commenters quickly piled up. One in particular came from one of her neighbors, who says that the Boca Police Department was knocking on all nearby doors, telling everyone inside to evacuate the area so that they could handle the bomb properly. Pretty crazy, huh? Just keep all this in mind the next time you see your son digging around in the backyard. And thank goodness for the authorities, as this story definitely could have gone a much different direction. Gang of mountain lions. So before we're able to move on, you guys know that this is when we get to do our special shout out. With that said, today's special recognition goes to none other than Brandon Ghostvada, who just the other day left us a comment that read, "I love your videos. Keep it up. You are the best YouTuber and my favorite YouTuber. Hashtag Supreme Family." Hey, Brandon, thanks for the love, man. Thanks for watching, and thanks for naming us your favorite channel out there. And don't forget, we've got a brand new video being posted every single day. So swing on back tomorrow for some more brand new content. So this next story is super scary. And sometimes, while I may think that living in old Cleveland, Ohio is boring, well, this is just one thing that I'll never have to worry about. Check it out. In Colorado, during the spring of 2018, four big old mountain lions can be seen just freely roaming across people's property. What in the world? Now, I can't believe that sights like this are a normal thing here in America, but Jefferson County was put on high alert when this video started making its rounds, and it got so popular that a local news team actually had to pick up the story. Mountain lions, or what's also called pumas and or cougars, can survive and even thrive in just about any type of ecosystem they can find. They're known to be able to jump up to 15 feet into the air or cover an area almost 40 feet long with just a single jump. That's pretty insane, right? And as a matter of fact, aside from humans, these animals have the widest geographic range of any land animal, meaning that I may have to worry about them wandering in Cleveland sometime soon. And that's a scary thought. Now, those residents in Jefferson County are used to the wildlife, which is important because then the children can grow up with that innate sense to always be aware of their surroundings and not to just keep an eye on the people in their area, but to also make sure that they aren't being stalked by any of the biggest and most dangerous cats in the world as well. Do you want to get a shout out in one of our daily videos? Well, don't forget to drop a comment down below with the hashtag Supreme Family. Tomorrow could be your day. Now, let's get back to the topic. Foxtrot. From mountain lions to foxes, our final clip of the day is actually a bit more humorous than it is creepy or scary. We'll actually stick around in Colorado for the final few moments, as we told you that their wildlife is a bit on to the next level. Before we show you what happened, though, this is probably a good time to tell you that you've got to be extra careful when you're dealing with wild animals. I know that you probably already know that, but we've got kids watching. And sometimes when you see an animal that appears to be cute and docile, well, it could actually switch it up in an instant if it decides that it needs to resort back to its wild animal instincts. So if you haven't learned anything yet today, I'm here to tell you that wild animals are still wild. So approach with caution. Anyway, here you can see wild foxes just having a good old time in someone's backyard as they dance on a trampoline. Now, it's almost kind of unbelievable that they are getting as much joy out of this as my kids do whenever they get to spend hours bouncing up and down on one of those things. But it's clear that these foxes aren't so shy when it comes to getting their bounce on. So how much would it take for you to climb in there and get your jump on with them? Well, actually, I take that question back. We certainly aren't trying to encourage anyone to go out and jump around with a group of wild foxes by any means. Besides, you won't even be able to spend any of that cash if you get mauled by a bunch of foxes. And that's today's video. If you like today's video, leave a thumbs up and share it with all your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that you never have to miss out on any of our interesting videos ever again.